Let's see the introduction of solid state. Earlier in first year states of matter, we discussed about the three states of matter that are possible. Matter, what is matter? Matter is anything that has some mass and occupies some volume is said to be matter. Matter exists in three states, we know that. Earlier we discussed in first year. The three states of matter are solid, liquid and gaseous state. These are the three main states of matter possible. In this about gaseous state and liquid state, we discussed in first year. Now about solid state. The three states of matter are possible by the two opposing forces, by the influence of two opposing forces. What are they? First one, intermolecular forces. Second one, thermal energy. These are the two forces that are responsible for the physical state of matter. One is intermolecular forces, other one thermal energy. About these two forces and their influence we discussed in first year. Let's see in brief, how do they influence the physical state of matter? Intermolecular forces and thermal energy, these are the two opposing forces which give the physical state of matter at a certain temperature and pressure. Intermolecular forces tend to make the atoms together, whereas thermal energy makes the atoms apart from each other. So if intermolecular force is dominating, then particles, they come closer and they change the physical state. See here, if you take a solid and liquid gaseous states of matter, solid, liquid, gas phases of matter, when intermolecular force is predominating over thermal energy, a gas is converted into liquid, a liquid is converted into solid. So in this conversion, what happens? Gas to liquid, liquid to solid. In this conversion, intermolecular forces increases, thermal energy decreases. When thermal energy predominates over intermolecular forces, then the change, reverse change occurs. That means a gas is converted into liquid, a liquid is converted into solid. At a low temperature, what happens? At a certain low temperature, thermal energy is very less. That's why intermolecular forces makes the particles to come closer and to clinch with each other. Finally, they get fixed positions. So when they get fixed positions, the substance then occupies, occupies solid state. So solid state is due to more predominance of intermolecular forces over thermal energy. About the three states of matter and their characteristics we discussed earlier in first year. Now, let's see about the characteristics of solid state.